All right, hey everybody, this is Levi here from the Buzzcut Boy, and today I'm bringing you a little bit of commentary here. I'm playing some Domination on Dome, and as you can see here, I am going to be using the, the P90. I believe it was with a red dot sight and rapid fire, I can't remember right. I know this weapon, I don't think it's been considered technically newbie yet. It might be on its way there, I wouldn't be surprised. This weapon is really good. It excels very much at close quarters combat. I like it because it has a good clip size. Obviously, that's one of the big things. I'm a sprayer, and when I say sprayer, I don't mean to think of that as just like spray and pray. I have no skill, but long story short, my accuracy statistic is really low. I have like 10.8 accuracy, or percent, yeah, accuracy. That's pretty bad. As you can see here, like, I sprayed really bad there. I don't aim down the sights as much as I probably should sometimes, and that often is a problem. But yeah, I'm using the red dot here because I wasn't a big fan of the iron sights, and because I was trying to do the challenges to rank this up. Yeah, I'm still working on getting gold for it, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to get it because I still have, like, halfway to go to level 31. And, I'm, like, level 75, so I might prestige before then. But anyway, so today, before I get into my main topic, I wanted to let you know a couple things. First of all, Happy New Year, everybody. It's 10:10 p.m. on 1/1/2012, and like I said earlier, I was going to make a video every day for 5 days, no matter what, so here I am, third day. Today's a pretty good day. Let's see, what all happened today? I wrote an essay, I went to church. I got home from church, I played some Ultimate Frisbee, it's so fun, but it's really windy, so it kind of stunk. So I played some Skyward Sword today, which, by the way, guys, that game is so much fun, okay? I like Modern Warfare 3, it's still one of my favorite games, okay? You have no idea, though, Skyward Sword is so much fun. And by the way, I seem to get so many IMSs from care packages, but anyway, I need to stop saying "but anyway," you guys. I'm sorry about that. This is kind of a long commentary, so if you're able to stick with it the whole time, congratulations. I might give you an internet cookie. So, now into our main topic today. I was thinking, I was actually sitting on the toilet thinking to myself, what would be a good commentary, Leroy? And I was like, well, this has to do with YouTube. Everything that I'm doing right now, this all has to do with YouTube. So I decided, I was like, that's a good idea. I was thinking, how about this? So my main question here today is, what brings you to YouTube? Why is YouTube appealing to you? And more or less, like, what on YouTube is appealing to you? Who is appealing? What is appealing? Like, I don't even know what I'll describe. Like, so first of all, what is appealing? Well, obviously it's the videos on there, but is it more the videos individually, or is it more channels that you can, like, relate to or think are funny or that sort of thing? Like, is it more of an individual basis? Is it more of, like, an individual channel basis? Like, for example, Nigahiga is, like, really high up in subscribers. Really, M. Johnson's really high. I don't really like his videos. Nigahiga's pretty funny, though. Like, a lot of the big solo channels, or is it more the single videos? Like, you know, I don't know, like, the Star Wars Jedi Kid, or the, I don't know, the Nyan Cat, and, Charlie Bit Me, and Gingers Do Have Souls, okay? And all those videos, like, what is it that's more appealing to you? Now, I am subscribed, my personal channel, by the way, is WC Buzzcut Boy. Personal channel is The Buzzcut Boy. I do Let's Plays on that channel, and a lot of other cool stuffs, but, I am subscribed to, I believe, 56 people. Now, some of those people are, like, just my friends I know from school, so I just subscribe to be nice, and they never make videos. A good majority of those are quote-unquote YouTube celebrities, and I consider a YouTube celebrity really anyone with, like, 100,000 subscribers or more. And then, actually, I have a lot more YouTube sub-celebrities, which I consider less than 1,000, but more than 1,000, but less than 100,000, so that whole range there, than most people. Like, for example, one person I really like, Aeropod Maniac, he does a lot of glitch videos, which I don't really like glitches, it kind of ruins the game, especially Outpost, hint hint, patch it, Treyarch. Yeah, he makes a lot of other videos too, and he's really good. He's a cool guy, it seems like. I'd really like to meet him. And then the other one, Iconboy, is huge. He is awesome, you guys. If you don't know who Iconboy is, he makes videos for Call of Duty Wii. And by the way, I think I threw a care package inside. That was so dumb. But yeah, he makes videos for Call of Duty Wii. He's pretty much the best commentator out there. He's really nice and stuff. Also, there's like Call of Duty Wii Cinema is pretty awesome. They have like, it's like a community channel, but it's just for the Wii, for Call of Duty. So it helps like the Wii in general, I guess, get stronger and rise. So new commentators, hint hint, like me, are able to like see what's going on, I guess. But nevertheless, who used that phrase anymore? That's what I'm wondering. So like, yeah, and then of course at the bottom there's always those channels with like less than 1,000 subscribers that you gotta love. I'm trying to think. I have a few that are like that. Yeah. But you gotta, when you really think about it, I mean, easily 80 or so percent of the channels on YouTube have less than, I don't know, maybe 50 subscribers, and like 95% have less than 100, and 99% have less than 1,000. So really, it's just these big, most people, I don't know how to describe it. Most people don't really make videos. But the people who do make videos are watched by the majority. So, if you're wondering where I'm going with this, this has kind of been all over the map. I want you to know, if you are watching this video right now, what brings you to watching my videos? What is it? Is it the single video? Are you just liking this video in general? Do you watch my videos consistently? I don't know. Let me know in the comments. But that's what I'd like to know. Also, if you guys have any ideas on how it all works, it'd be really cool, because I'm just wondering to myself, like, how, I don't get how it all works. Like, the way that, what, 6 billion, or 7 billion now, people on this planet, and there's, like, I don't even know, there's been, like, 70 million, zillion, billion views on YouTube. How do all these people come together to one place? Well, I know YouTube is also appealing in their regards that it, you know how, in school a lot, they've actually been teaching us about this. But there's like auditory learners that learn best from hearing and stuff, and then there's visual learners and other stuff like that. But like YouTube is both. Like the thing about it, especially for tutorials, you can see what's going on and you can hear what's going on. So it's like you're there. It's a really good explanation for all sorts of things. Almost every type of video on YouTube that's not meant to entertain is meant to inform. And it's a great way to do that. It's just like you're right there in the room with them, showing them what to do. I don't know, maybe you're trying to make, like, you know, those, like, paper ninja stars. And watch a tutorial on that. Or even, like, my video right here. You're learning about Call of Duty. Or maybe not. Maybe you're just listening to my commentary. Because I'm not a very good player. My KD's just barely above 1. So, yeah, guys, now that you've listened to my whole spiel, let me know. I don't really know if there's anything else I really want to talk about. I guess I can actually talk about the game now. First of all, Dome, I know it's been a while, but Dome, I knew, is going to be, like, the next Nuketown. Not to that proportion, but it will be the next Nuketown, as in the high-scoring gameplays are going to be on this map. So much of it is open, except for that one building right where I'm facing around now. I don't even know if I'm gonna have this synced up right, so you'll never really know. But you know what I'm talking about, the one building, air support can just rain down once they patch it, hint hint. So yeah. By the way, that's one thing that's really bugging me, the air support not being patched, because I really want to be able to use kill streaks from like 07 to 12 from that attack helicopter, the Pavlo. But with like 4 out of 5 of those kill streaks are air support. And I can't use them. So the only one I can really use is the assault drone, which is kind of useless on the Wii, because it's really hard to control, especially with the Wii Zapper. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching this commentary. It's kind of been all over the map. Like I said, if you're still here, congratulations, everybody. You just won an internet cookie. So yeah, want a cookie? Let me know. Alright, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Leave your answers in the comments. Let me know what you think. Like this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And yeah, you're welcome for the gameplay that has a KD of more than two, because that's pretty rare. Just kidding, I don't suck that bad. I see everybody.